Hey guys, welcome to Professor X Lab. We are now in XCMG Experience Hall. As you can see, we are all surrounded by all these hydraulic components. It's not hard to guess the topic of today. That's right, we are going to talk about hydraulic. We are glad to have invited XCMG's hydraulic master, Wang Jiachong, to star as Professor X today.
我叫王家聪, 来自徐工液压件有限公司。
Professor X, I think a lot of us are curious about how hydraulic technology works. So what exactly is cold drawing?
这就是冷拔机。冷拔的制作原理其实跟面条是比较接近的。在常温的条件下，通过一个大的拉拔力，使钢管变长、变薄，变得越来越紧密。That
sounds great. So how can we make good use of this technology?
现在国内100吨级以上的启动机械油缸基本上都是冷拔方法制作的。冷拔制作的油缸更加的耐磨损，使用过程中也不容易损坏。我们现在出口到澳大利亚的400吨挖机油缸已经在矿场上使用了超过10万小时了。As
far as I know, the hot rolling technology has been widely used in the machine industry for years, which is mature enough. Why do we need to develop cold drawing machines?
这个与产品效率和公司的发展有关。冷拔钢管做出来的油缸更加的长、更加的变薄、重量更加轻，可以贴着吊臂，是一节一节的伸出去。过去没有冷拔钢管的时候，热轧技术没解决这些难题。由于冷拔技术的发展，解决了三个问题：第一个是冷拔管的强度更高了。 满足了强度要求。另一个是冷拔管的效率提高了，降低了制造成本。另外一个，冷拔以后，起重机的重量降低了。Has
our manufacturing capacity remarkably increased with cold drawing?
有啊，目前我们的冷拔钢管产量已经可以达到5000多吨，随着明年新冷拔机的投产，预计明年我们可以达到10000吨。Cool. 有了这个新建的冷拔线，新冷拔机最长可以达到18米，相当于6层楼高。最大冷拔力可以达到600吨，相当于1头大象的重量。冷拔管批量出口近20多个国家和地区，庞大的客户群遍及工程机械、港口机械，为各行业贡献出一个源自中国的世界级液压品牌。 这台设备就是我们的起重机的工况模拟实验装置，这个油缸就是用我们的冷拔钢管进行制造的。I
know R&D can't be done without teamwork. Could you share with us about the story of your team?
冷拔钢管的生产对于公司当时属于新产品，一切都是从零开始的。经过不断的探索，最终可以生产出冷拔尺寸精度和机械性能满足要求的产品。And
their efforts paid off.
对呀，2007年，公司成功研发出中国行业内起重机最大直径280毫米的油缸，那时候国际上可以生产到350毫米。经过5年的时间，现在我们已经可以生产出直径480毫米的冷拔管了。Thank
you, Professor X. I had a lot of fun today, and I hope you enjoy the experiments too. If you like our video, don't forget to like and comment below to let us know. See you in the next episode.
See you.